Hello, everybody. Andrea Majewski here. How is everybody's studying doing and going? Probably intense. You're probably nervous. Please don't worry. Okay, so I want to talk about studying a little bit. I've probably mentioned this many times before, so sorry if I sound like a broken record, but some of you might have not heard me say this. So what is the best way to study to really retain the information, okay? So if you're taking the board exam soon, the pressure's on. Even if you're taking the board exam in 6 months, okay? So there's a different way to study depending on when you're taking the board exam. But the rule of thumb is study at least 2 hours every day, a maximum of 6 hours, okay? I don't want you studying 8 hours, 12 hours. I don't want you to wake up at 2 a.m. to study. I don't want you staying up until 2 a.m. to study. Do not do that, because studying is stressful to begin with, especially when you first start to study a new topic. When I was in school, what I did and found that worked for me was I would literally open up my PowerPoint on special needs, okay? Say I had a special needs test in 2 weeks. I would open up that PowerPoint as soon as I got that PowerPoint. So it was usually 2 weeks before the test, even sometimes only a week before. But I would open it up right away and start studying right away. As soon as you study a new topic, you will read through everything and you'll feel like afterwards, okay, I just studied for 2 hours and I learned nothing. That's normal, okay? It's very, very normal. But when you go back to study that PowerPoint again the next day for an hour, maybe 2 hours, you will retain a little bit more. Even if you only study an hour because you have other things to study for, and you're thinking, okay, well, Andrea told me to study at least 2 hours every day, so I'm going to take an hour to study for special needs and then another hour to study for my oral pathology test coming up. So even if you study that special needs for 1 hour, afterwards, you'll still be thinking, okay, I didn't really learn anything. Like, what the heck is this? I learned nothing. Okay, that is still normal. But guess what? You have learned more than you did the night before. Sorry, I just lost my train of thought here. The night before. You might not know it yet, but you have. Keep doing that every day. Read over the same things. You will retain the information. By day number 4 was when I would start to go, okay, I'm reading through this information a lot quicker now because I'm starting to remember it where I don't have to stop and kind of read it like this, read it over again and be like, okay, next page. Okay, read it, do that. I would be able to skim through and almost know, okay, so this page talks about this. Okay, I remember that. So I can go to the next page. By day 4, it gets easier. Come test time, you'll be studying that same PowerPoint that took you 2 hours a day to study for 3 days and then an hour a day on day 4, an hour a day, day 5. By day 6, you will be looking through that whole PowerPoint in half an hour and you can take your test, okay? That's the best way to study. It might not work for you, but that worked for me. So find what works for you. But just in case you're wondering, that's what really worked for me, was to study a little bit at a time. And by day 6, even by day 4, as I said, things got easier. And by day 6, I felt pumped and ready to take the test. So for the board exam, obviously you have multiple PowerPoints to study for, right? So take a different topic every hour to mix things up a bit. If you're on a roll and you want to study pharmacology for 3 hours, go for it. That's totally fine. But then the next day, study something else, okay? So try to mix it up. And when I say mix it up, I mean sometimes look at your notes, sometimes look at mock exams, sometimes listen to me teaching you something. Mix it up so you don't get bored. Put the cell phones away. Do not look at your cell phones. When I was a student, cell phones weren't available. We literally did, I mean, we had cell phones, but they were not the iPhones and you couldn't really do much on them. So I'm so happy that I didn't have to deal with that when I was a student. that would be very distracting. But yeah, so put those cell phones away. Last week, oh yes, I wanted to also say, when you are studying, take breaks. Do not study 6 hours straight. Study 2 hours in the morning, have lunch, study 2 hours after that, go out and do some shopping, go for a walk, watch a movie, and then study after that, okay? Do the best you can, but take breaks. When I was a student, if I was in school all day and then I had to work at night till about 11, I would not be able to get 2 hours in, but I would make sure to get an hour in before I went to bed. And then I would try to get that hour in, because I said 2 hours minimum, right, a day. I would try to get another hour in during my lunch break at school, on the bus ride home, whatever. Okay, so 2 hours minimum, 6 hours maximum. Okay, don't study more than that. I hope that helped you guys. Good luck studying, have fun, and I'll see you in the next one.